Today, I'm going to talk to you about a big problem we encountered, which we affectionately dubbed the fake join, and what we did to solve it.
In my 20 years in information retrieval, I never heard of an Elasticsearch cluster quite like this, of this size. We were dealing with a scale of 350 nodes.
To be world-class at go-to-market means that your sales and marketing teams are going to need a lot of data and a lot of technology. As our customer footprint has continued to grow and expand, the needs we have on our business to serve fast, reliable, and accurate data to our customers has come along with it.
Sometimes we encounter a couple problems with that. Today, I'm going to talk to you about a big problem we encountered, which we affectionately dubbed the fake join, and what we did to solve it. A bit of a simplification, but at Apollo, we have two core data models, contacts and accounts. We actually try to synchronize as much information as possible from the account onto the contact. For example, if a contact's account goes from having about 200 employees to about 500 employees, we'll synchronize that information right back to the contact. This allows us to provide our end users with speedy querying, for example. It's only querying on a single object.
We knew Federate was robust, but this scale and complexity pushed us into a new territory. The scale of the concurrent user, data size, and number of machines involved means we have to improve how to maintain stability, uptime, and reliability across the board.
But not all of our fields are so easily indexable. Picture an account that has about 150,000 contacts associated with it. It might have a field like account owner, which any user could change several times in a couple seconds. We can't have that queuing up millions of Elasticsearch reindex operations that would never be performant across any system. Well, for our internal sales team and our enterprise customers, this was increasingly becoming a roadblock. We would be returning incorrect results, missing results, massively underestimating our users' TAM.
The fake join was broken. It just didn't scale.
In my 20 years in information retrieval, I never heard of an Elasticsearch cluster quite like this, of this size. We were dealing with a scale of 350 nodes. The goal was to make sure the platform could support that scale seamlessly while maintaining short response time.
When we first picked up this item, which was an engineering-led initiative, by the way, we had no idea where to start. We started doing some research, and eventually Akshay pointed us towards Siren Federate, and we ended up reaching out to them. When we first went down this path, there was a lot of skepticism that we'd be able to make these foundational changes to how searches are done at Apollo. Even when we started to overcome that, performance was a big consideration. And our initial conservative goal was maybe we could get our 50 largest customers onto this solution to at least alleviate the pain for them.
Working with Apollo has been an insightful experience and a huge validation of what we set out to achieve with Siren Federate. We essentially built a new type of aggregation, enabling custom drill-down view based on the Siren Federate join technology.
Eventually, I found out Renaud is a founder of Siren and the architect of Siren Federate, which was crazy to me because here I was thinking this was just the friendly, smart engineer I met with every Friday. Renaud spent a ton of time with our system and infrastructure, looking at our Siren setup, our Elasticsearch setup, and really doing a lot of bespoke development, debugging, and understanding to help us figure out if this could be the solution for us moving forward.
I also really enjoy working with the Apollo team. They have a really good understanding of the Elasticsearch technology stack.
Our products are faster. Our customers can use our products in more precise ways, allowing sales and marketing teams to really filter and target the way they go to market. This has led them to have unparalleled results.
Users are no longer suffering partial results, queries that are too long or too complex to even execute. Our average search time is now 1.2 seconds through the Federate solution, which is a far, far jump down from what the fake join was, or even our initial Federate query time, which was about 5 to 7 seconds on average when we had started using the product. We're really grateful to Renaud and the team for helping us constantly optimize that number down.
Siren for us really shines through with how we handle our enterprise search volume. This gives us capabilities to have a large, complex search at Apollo complete in around 1 second. This happens because Siren has enabled us to get the most out of Elasticsearch, quickly allowing us to take these advanced joins and search criteria that customers give us and give back the customer the data they need in record time.
I can happily say now, many months later, 100% of all Apollo join traffic is routed through the Federate solution, which has been amazing. And we've been able to clean up our older code paths, make our code base neater, and finally delete the old fake join solution.
So this rollout pushed our entire development process forward, making Federate even more robust. I have to say, I'm proud of all we've risen to the challenge.
I am really happy to have this issue in my rearview mirror now. We used to generate about 30 support tickets a month. Now we're down to zero, and I can finally be done joining customer calls and trying in vain to explain this weird technical issue. The average federated search returns 50% more results now, or about an additional 400,000 contacts per each search. I'm really happy my 2025 roadmap now doesn't need to involve fixing weird issues like this, and we can move our product forward and our integration with Siren forward. And I look forward to collaborating with them this year and beyond.
It's exciting to see the future of Federate take shape with real-world impact, and knowing we're setting a new standard in investigative search capability, scalability, and performance.
Now, in my role as a COO, I also care a lot about efficiency. And not only is this a huge win for ourselves and our customers, but we also saved a lot on our IT costs. It's been also very exciting for our engineering teams to know that we're staying on the cutting edge of technology, and our engineering teams leverage tools like Siren to keep us going as the disruptor in this space. Thank you, Siren.